In this video, I want to show you several ways to manage links in your SharePoint site. We can add links over here. This is called the Quick Launch Toolbar. We can add links up here. That's called the Top Launch Toolbar. So then there'll be other ways to add links as well. So first of all, let's go into our site contents. And this would be everything that you've added to the site. Document folders, different apps. Any one of those can be a link. So I'm gonna go to where it says team calendar and click there. And what you do is you capture the URL up here. So I'm gonna right click on the URL and I'll say copy. We'll go back to the home page. Now let's go ahead and add that as a link over here. So I'll pick on edit links. Now, by the way, in order to do this, you have to have be a contributor to the site or an owner. So when you do this on your site, you may not have the privilege to even do it. So let's assume that this shows up. If not, you have to find somebody else that would help you do that. I'll pick on edit links. And I'm going to add a link. And let's say team calendar. That's the text that will display. Then I'm just going to paste it in of what I had copied. And I'm going to click on OK. Now, you could try the link over there, but I'm pretty sure it's going to work. And you see there's the team calendar. Now, at this point, you can also move it up and down. So I can just pick it up and drag it like that. Now, notice how some of the links are indented. Here's how you can do that. If I picked up the team calendar and moved it onto the word pages right here, then it would be indented within pages, as you can see. So if you move it kind of up on the main level like that, it'll be on the main level. But if you move it within one of those, then you can make that, see how that just indented under the team documents. So that's how you can kind of make one of those subheadings. Just move it on top of another heading and just hover there for a second and it would make it a subheading like that. I'm actually going to move the team calendar so it's maybe over here. Good. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and pick on save. Let's try that again. I'll go to the site contents. This time, I'm going to go to the app that's called Team Tasks. And you capture the URL up here. From here, I'll pick on edit links. We'll add a new link. And I'll say Team Tasks. And we're going to paste that right in. Good. And now maybe I'll move the team task right below the team calendar just by dragging it. Perfect. I'll pick on save. Now, another place you can put that link is up here. This is called the Top Launch Toolbar. So I'm going to go ahead and pick on edit links. And you do the same kind of thing. Say team tasks. And we'll paste that right in. Good. And now you can see it appears over there. So those work in a very similar way. I'll pick on save. Now, another way to get to both of those lists is the following. We can pick on the settings wheel. Then we can pick on site settings. Now, again, you have to be a site owner or an admin or a contributor to be able to get to this. I'll pick on site settings. Now, you're looking for things over here. There's one that's called Quick Launch. When I go into there, then you can make a new link. Now, a heading, the word recent here is a heading. That's where you can make your sub list. So, for example, I'll pick on new heading. And in this case, I'll paste that right in again. And I'll type in tasks. And you can see that that is now in your in the Quick Launch Toolbar. And it showed up over here as well. Now, it doesn't have to be a SharePoint site. It could be any kind of website, really. So if I pick on New navigation link. Then in this case, I'll do www.freepcseminars.com. That's one of my home pages for my company. And I'll say Tom Fragale's site. And now see where it says heading. You can put that, you can now make that a sub listing into one of your headings over here. So I'll pick on home, for example, and we'll pick on OK. And notice now Tom Fragale's site is now a subheading under home. All right, now we can also change the order and move things up and down. So this is just another way. It's the same thing as going into edit links. It's just a different way to do it. Now we're going to put this away. I could have also gone to the site settings and changed the top link toolbar in the same way, as you can see. All right. Now it says, when it says use links from parent. So the parents, this is a team site. This is really a subsite of the parent site. If I want to inherit the links from the parent site, I can use that over here, and then those will show up on the top. Either way is perfectly fine. Let me go back to the home page. Now, another way to use links, let's say your team site has a lot of websites that you want to share. Then you would make an app that's called Links. In this case, I'm going to go to Site Contents. And we'll pick on New. And we'll add an app. And one of the apps is called Links. So let's say there's a lot of websites that you want to feature. Then you maybe we'll make an app. So then I'll call this one Team Links. Notice now we'll have an app that's called Team Links. Now I might even make that as a link over here. So I'll pick on, I'm going to go to the app that's called Team Links. Once again, we're going to capture the URL, copy that. And in this case, I'm going to go and pick on the home toolbar, and then I'll pick on edit links. I'll add a new link, and here I'll say important links, and we'll paste that right in, and I'll click on OK. Good. We're going to save that. Now, when I pick on the important links link, it'll just open up an app where we can add many links from there. So in this case, I'll pick on new. Here you can have folders, and that'll just be a collection of the links, and we can add an item. http://www.freepcseminars.com. Site, and you can put notes there as well. I'll pick on save, and you can see that's in there. Let's do another link. HTTP. Now, of course, I can paste these in as well. www.youtube.com. And I'll pick on save there. And we'll do one more. Pick on new, and then item. I'll say http www.microsoft.com. Put in a description, of course. And we'll pick on save there. Let's see what happens when we put the notes in. And I'll pick on save. Now the notes show up and it gives a little bit more of a description, as we can see. So I showed you how to add links to your quick launch toolbar. I also showed how to add links to your top link toolbar. Another way we can get to those, if I pick on home, then here I have edit links there. We have edit links there. The other way I showed you was to go into the site settings. I'll pick on the settings wheel and then the site settings, and we can manage those things there. Then I also showed you that we can add it as an app. And then once it's an app, we can add the app for the links itself onto the top link toolbar or the quick launch toolbar. So when I pick on the import links, then it'll show the links that we've added in there. Hopefully you have an idea now of how to add your links to your SharePoint site.